Hello students, yes, I am back again, and this time a poem, a lot of requests, the daffodils. So daffodils is a very easy poem. Many of you must have read it in class 6 or 7 also. Even I, when I was in class 7, I read it, and this was also a very good piece for elocution. So I have read daffodils myself when I was in school, and since then a fondness for William Wordsworth had developed within me, a nature poet. And after that, though, in all these nearly 25 years, I'll complete 25 years 10th August. So in this tenure, I have been teaching daffodils for I don't know how many times. To ICSE students, yes, not only that, they had it in CBSE at one time, and in the junior classes, 6, 7, in Radiant Reader also. So anyway, let's start it. But again, as I always do, what do? I tell y'all that please subscribe to my channel if you have not up till now, and watch the full video. Press the like button. You must have already by-hearted it. Press the like button if you have liked it. Please do. The daffodils. William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth is noted for his poems on nature. He is supposed to be a nature poet. Actually, he belonged to the Romantic age, when we had poets like Keats, Shelley, Byron and Wordsworth. They were the four famous Romantic poets. And well, Wordsworth lived the most. He lived till a ripe age of 80. Whereas all these three died young. So all of them, they wrote more or less either about nature or about common people. So before this, poems were written on great people or some great incident. But these romantic poets, they shifted the genre and the object of their poem, or the subject of their poem, whatever you say, the subject of their poem was either nature or common people. So here it is nature again. Daffodils, a very nice poem. You'll really enjoy it. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. So this is a true experience. Wordsworth's poems, most of them are emotions recollected in tranquility. That means he experiences these. Whatever he writes, he has already experienced them, but he immediately doesn't come and write it. Much later, he recollects them. And then when he's in a peaceful mood, he writes it. So emotions recollected in tranquility. This is the principle of Wordsworth. This is the principle he follows when he writes his poems. So Wordsworth, the poet, was wandering lonely as a cloud. So this is a simile. The poet is comparing himself to a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills. Vales is poetic English, old English. We don't use it nowadays for valleys. So the cloud which floats over valleys and hills high up in the sky. Who was wandering like the clouds? The poet. And what happened? When all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. So suddenly, as he was wandering all to himself, he is attracted by the scene of the daffodils. A crowd, a host of golden daffodils. Daffodil is a golden colored flower. So suddenly he is attracted by the sight of the golden colored daffodils. And where did he see them? Beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. So this is an example of personification. The daffodils are being compared to human beings. They were fluttering and dancing in the breeze. So the first verse tells you about the lonely state of the poet, where he compares himself to a cloud, and then suddenly he is attracted by the sight of the golden colored daffodils. Quite a lot, they were numerous, a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. And what were these daffodils doing? They were fluttering and dancing in the breeze. And where were they doing this? Beside the lake, beneath the trees. Now again, there is a simile in the next verse. Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way, they stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. So here, the daffodils are compared to the stars that shine on the Milky Way. So the stars, they shine on the Milky Way, they are numerous. In the same way, the daffodils are also numerous. And what were these daffodils doing? They were stretching in a never-ending line along the margin of a bay. Bay is a water body, here, like Bay of Bengal. But here, there is no Bay of Bengal. Here the lake, beside the lake, in the first verse, the poet has already said. So the bay here refers to the lake. So beside the lake, along the margin of the lake, the daffodils stretched in a never-ending line. That means the line of daffodils went on stretching till a great distance. 10,000 saw I at a glance. 10,000 is an example of a hyperbole, exaggeration. He has not counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in that way, 10,000. It's a way of saying. Many times now you must have heard your parents or your mother especially say, 1,000 times I have told you not to do it. Like na, they say, hazar bar mana kiya hai. Don't they say it like this? 1,000 times I have told you, don't do this, and yet you have done it. So it is like that. She also never tells you 1,000 times. It's a way of saying. So this is an example of, what do we call it? Hyperbole. No, not hyperbole. Don't pronounce it that. The spelling is hyperbole. Okay. 10,000 saw I at a glance. In one glance, how can you see 10,000? So what does he really mean to say is that at a glance, he saw a number of daffodils tossing their heads in sprightly dance, in a very lively dance, tossing, shaking their heads. Again, personification. The next one, next verse, again a comparison. The waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. So the waves of the lake, they are also dancing. And the daffodils are also dancing. But who is a better performer? Who performs better? Or who dances better? The daffodils, according to the poet. They, here refers to the daffodils, outdid the sparkling waves in glee. Sparkling waves, why? Because the rays of the sun, they fall on the waves, and as such the waves sparkle. So sparkling waves in glee means happiness. So the waves are dancing happily, the daffodils are dancing happily. But the daffodils, according to the poet, surpass the waves in their happy dances. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. So when the poet is standing and watching the waves as well as the merry daffodils, how can he not remain happy? How can he remain untouched? How can he not be merry in such a merry company, in such a happy or gay company? I gazed and gazed, but little thought. Here, little thought doesn't mean thought little. No, little thought means did not think at all. So I gazed and gazed, but did not think at all. What? What wealth the show to me had brought. That time he did not realize how valuable this show was. He will realize it later. When? In the last verse. For oft. Oft is old English for often. For oft when on my couch I lie in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude. And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils. So what happens when he is lying in his couch, either in a vacant means empty, or in a sad mood, pensive mood, then what happens? They here refers to the daffodils. They flash upon that inward eye, your mind's eye, the eye of imagination. That means he sees them as if in a vision. They don't physically appear before him, but in a vision, they appear before him, which is the bliss of solitude. This happiness can be obtained when you are all to yourself, when you are in solitude. In a crowded room, you cannot experience this happiness. This happiness can be experienced only when you are alone. So they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude. And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils. So what happens when he sees the vision, or his mind's eye opens up and he sees the daffodils dancing? Then his heart is filled with pleasure and starts dancing with the daffodils. So I told you it's a very easy poem, very nice one. Now, what are the things you have to keep in mind while, again, as I repeat it, while preparing for your exams? It will be the title, of course. Title is very appropriate. Not only that, there are some figures of speech. Like alliterations. Alliteration, I think by now you know what an alliteration means. That means when the consonant sounds, they are repeated again and again. Like, I wandered lonely as a cloud, that floats on high over vales and hills. High over vales and hills. H and H. There will be many more. 10,000 saw I at a glance, TT. And then an example of personification. Like a host of golden daffodils beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Throughout, the daffodil has been personified. Achha, then 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. So here also, they are being personified. Then again, the waves. The waves beside them danced. A personification is here used to give a sense of a living being. So the waves are also being personified as if they can dance. But they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. So again, the daffodils. We have an example. We have several examples of simile I told you earlier also. Like, I wandered lonely as a cloud, as, and continuous as the stars that shine. There is also an example of metaphor. If you are wondering what a metaphor is, let me tell you that simile and metaphor both are comparisons. But in a metaphor, we don't use the words like or as. But the comparison is there. Like, I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills. So first line is a simile and the second line is a metaphor. Here the clouds are compared to boats that sail in the water. So that floats on high over vales and hills. And hyperbole, I told you, 10,000 saw I at a glance. And imagery, so Wordsworth's poems obviously will be rich in imagery, he being a nature poet. The scenery, natural scenery, it is quite calm, peaceful, and also a very happy one. So the lakes, the field, the trees, stars, clouds. Wordsworth is very happy when he sees the daffodils. And not only that, when he sees the waves dance and the daffodils dance, his heart is filled. He cannot remain untouched. Or when he sees the vision of the daffodils also, he feels very happy. So the poem begins again in pessimism. He wandered lonely as a cloud. And the last line, where it ends in optimism, his heart starts dancing with the daffodils. So I think this is enough. The poem is easy. And if you prepare this, you can always refer to your workbooks. And again, I say, yes, you can go for Xavier Pinto's workbook because they are quite useful. So I hope there is nothing no more. If you have any problems in this poem also, I don't think you will have, but even then, if you have, you are free to put your problems in the comment section and I'll surely answer it. So bye for the time being, and have a nice day.